Solid waste management in Malaysia.
Solid waste management can be defined as a discipline associated with the control of waste generation, storage, collection, transfer and transport, processing and disposal of solid waste. Malaysia is a developing country that has recorded remarkable economic development consistently since its independence. The economic growth has brought prosperity, population increase, accelerated urbanization and industrialization. The waste generated in Malaysia in 2015 was 2.9 million tons at a recycling rate of 15.7%. The quantity rose to 4 million tons 4 years later in 2019, despite the recycling rate also increased to 28.1%. In this video, we are going to talk about challenges facing by Malaysia and the opportunities we have in sustainable solid waste management. First of all, limited space for landfills. There are 157 unsanitary landfills and 8 sanitary landfills in Malaysia. With some calculation, the waste that produced in a year by Malaysians are as much as to fill up a Putrajaya. But how many more Putrajaya can we fill in the future? So, landfills are very limited in Malaysia if waste generation keep on increasing. The second challenge is methane gas emission and other pollutants. In Malaysia, solid waste disposal site account about 18% of methane gas emission. Other toxic substances in landfills may penetrate the soil and pollute the land, underground water and river. Furthermore, rising costs of disposal happen as the volumes of waste generation increase, but limited space for landfill. Also, high costs needed in operating incinerators and to cure the methane gas emission in landfills to reduce the negative impacts on the environment and to human beings. As the saying goes, when there is a will, there is a way. Opportunities are something that brighten up sustainable waste management in Malaysia. To enhance solid waste management, Malaysia has taken a stepwise approach to prioritize and centralize its solid waste management. First, government provides targeted incentives to companies. Firms are encouraged to reduce commercial waste generated from manufacturing activities. Second, government had further extended the incentive for green technology through the budget 2014. The incentive aims to encourage firms to revise the approach by incorporating a combination of waste management techniques, including collection, storage, composting, and disposal with other core waste treatment activities. In parallel to the rapid expansion in economic growth, there has been a rise in environmental degradation in developing countries. Despite applying policy, practicing 3R method, cultivating household solid waste segregation, and banning of plastic to encourage consumer waste management through recycling efforts, it should be noted that the main contributors to waste is the externalities from industrial processes. Therefore, there is a great need to incorporate and shift to integrated and sustainable waste management practices on all levels to improve and maintain the environmental quality.